The Industrial Revolution gave rise to new ways of living, a wealthy middle class, and many new inventions. Perhaps the most important of the era was the steam engine. Before the invention of the steam engine, people used the power provided by animals, wind, and water to farm, mill flour, and transport goods and people. However, none of these sources of energy were as reliable as steam. Before the steam engine, factories still relied on wind or water power to drive their machines and were confined to certain locales. Steam allowed factories to be built anywhere, rather than just along fast-flowing rivers. Although invented as early as 1698 by Thomas Savery to pump water out of flooding mines, early steam engines were crude, inefficient, and prone to major malfunctions which often resulted in boiler explosions. It wasn't until 1712 when Thomas Newcomen developed the first steam-driven pump that steam power really began to take shape. Unlike earlier designs, which relied solely on steam pressure alone, Newcomen's engine featured a pump, which pulled the condensed steam upward as well as helped to equalize the machine's pressure with the atmospheric pressure, reducing the chance of a boiler explosion. In 1782, James Watt improved on this simple pumping engine by developing a separate chamber to condense steam. Subsequently, he created a steam pressure gauge and rotary engine that could drive various forms of machinery, such as the power loom. Power looms automated many parts of weaving, making the process faster and easier. Factories no longer needed skilled artisans to weave cloth. Many male workers were replaced with the cheaper labor of women and children. With this, both the cost of producing as well as the sale prices of textiles went down. For the first time, peasants could afford cotton undergarments, something that had been a luxury of the wealthy in the past. This use of child labor in factories inflicted major problems on the families and children. Children worked long hours in awkward positions with little time for rest. Many children developed deformities or were crushed when they were sent in to repair the giant machines. On top of that, a child was only paid, if at all, 1/10 that of a man. To ease some of the children's pain, Parliament passed the Factory Act in 1833. This limited the amount of hours children of certain ages could work. Children were also required to receive schooling for at least 2 hours a day. As England turned from a country that relied on trade and agriculture for its livelihood into one based on the manufacture of goods, they needed a way to deliver materials and products quickly. In 1803, Richard Trevithick built the first steam locomotive. Trevithick's invention was slowly improved upon over the years by new inventors such as George Stephenson, who created the first commercially available locomotive. Rocket could travel at speeds of 60 miles an hour while hauling 7 tons of iron, goods, and 34 people. Steam locomotives made it more efficient for factories to transport their goods across the country. The railroad rapidly spread and sped transportation. This created new jobs, forcing people to move into cities. Within only 30 years of the creation of the first commercially available steam locomotive, London's population grew from 1.1 million to a population of almost 3 million. The steam engine changed the world in a multitude of ways, not only economically, but also geographically. Factories were no longer limited to rivers and could be built closer to the sources of the raw materials and markets where their finished products were sold. The new machines developed from steam power required people to work them. This established a modern system of organized labor. Entire families moved from the rural countryside to be closer to the factories where they worked. By the late 1870s, the amount of people living in towns and cities had more than doubled. Steam-powered locomotives enabled the transport of people and goods over long distances, allowing industrialization around the world.